Emergency management is the science of coordinating activities in response to disasters. Emergency managers practice that science. My name is Jay Rohrbach, and I'm a lecturer in the emergency management degree program here at SUNY Canton. Our degree program teaches both the theory and the science and the practice of emergency management. So emergency managers plan for all hazards. Hazards turn into disasters due to human-environment interaction. And the important thing that we stress is that we need to consider everything, not only the hazard, but what are the consequences that it can cause, and what's the likelihood that it'll happen in a certain geographic area. The emergency manager is really the individual within a community that gathers all those functions together. It's that coordination piece that is really important to emergency management. I think our students, most of them end up being very successful and enjoying emergency management and learning so much about this coordination. And then the fact that it's applied in organizations or in communities in really austere disaster situations kind of gives a sense of accomplishment for students that they are helping within a community when a community might be at its worst. I tell the students all the time, just go on Indeed.com and do a job search for emergency management, and just don't limit it to a specific geographic area. And the amount of jobs that comes up is amazing.
If you are someone from an emergency background and you come into this course, what you will learn is you'll understand why your region responds the way they do, what to expect from private organizations, what to expect from the federal government, how responses should be taken, and the time frame behind them. It just brings everything full circle and just puts all the missing pieces that you didn't know and that you didn't think you needed to know. I feel like it puts it all together and gives you a big picture aspect so that you understand from beginning to end why we respond the way we do when there is an emergency.
So the demographic of the students in the emergency management program ranges in age from a first-time freshman that's right out of high school at age 18 to students in their 70s, actually. Because of the online and asynchronous nature of the courses, we have it set up where students have multiple days or even multiple weeks in which they can consume the materials that we post and complete assignments really on their schedule. The technology that we have at our disposal here at Canton through SUNY, the Brightspace Learning Management System, it's a really robust, technologically capable system Canton uses for online instruction. And I've had just overwhelming feedback from students for the ease of navigating through classes, the notifications that they get once the professors have the classes set up, and then the mobile app is probably one of the bigger things that we've incorporated into our class use too. And it really helps me as an instructor understand where those students are coming from, because I also work a full-time job. I have a family life, and it helps me relate a little bit to where they are. What I tell all the students in the emergency management majors when they come in and tell me what their goals are, that their goals become my goals. I want to see them succeed not only in the program, but as a former emergency manager, I want them to get the jobs that I had for 20 plus years. So it's really interesting. The type of student that we tend to attract is a little bit older. They do work full time. Some of them have prior credits from other institutions of higher education. And we work with them to kind of build the program that they will be most successful in.
I currently work for the emergency department, where we respond to emergencies pertaining to our equipment and the electricity that powers the city that I live in. I did look into the program a few times, but the fear of being able to juggle my work, my family life, and school, and being out of school for almost 20 years was something that held me back. And then once I started looking into it, I spoke to a few people. It did take me a little bit to sign up, but eventually I bit the bullet and I faced my fears. My fear was that I wouldn't be able to find the time to do the work or find the time to dedicate to the program. It wasn't about the work being difficult. I was surprised at how flexible the online courses were and how much time in between assignments I had and how I was able to sign on at my own leisure. And as long as I participated in the discussions with the other students and submitted my assignment on time, that I was able to get through my first course pretty easily. If you are afraid that you won't find the time to do the work and juggle personal and professional and schoolwork, you will find the time. You find the time to watch your series, your TV series. You find the time to hang out with your friends. If this is a goal that you want to set for yourself and your future and your career, and to set yourself up, you will find the time to make it happen like I did.